Hey guys, Andrew here. Welcome back to another episode of No One But You. When we last left off, we had just had a really high-intensity study session, and people got angry, mostly Yui and Megumi, since they're the only ones there, and things got a little heated. So after that, we also joined the literary club, or literature club, and with Chinatsu, and that's great, but I don't probably think I'll show up there ever again. So yeah, let's get back to the story then. It's a bit cloudy today. The weather has changed quite a bit since I arrived here. I've been here for almost 2 months now, but I'm still not used to everything. Like that bridge, for example. I like to go by there in order to see Chinatsu, but with those nightmares of mine, I just... Should I swing by there anyway? Take another route to school? Maybe not today. I'll face my fears some other day when I'm feeling less stressed. Arriving in class slightly earlier than usual, I looked around the classroom for the sources of my angst. Megumi is sitting at her desk alone. Maybe she's studying? Yui isn't here, so she's probably in the courtyard as usual. Maybe I should check on Yui before class starts. Check on Yui. Alright, why not? I still have time. Besides, it would be nice to hear Yui's side of the story before I interrogate Megumi. Yep, she's sitting on the bench like always. I started walking towards Yui. Hey there, Yui.
Also, it's really weird that there's no music in the background going on right now. I don't know if that's supposed to happen or if maybe something got bunked. I don't know. There's the music. Never mind. It queued in. I'm just an idiot.
Shh. No, no. I noticed that Yui was playing her on her handheld game console. Oh, I never knew you were a gamer. In fact, I was beginning to doubt the very existence of the legendary gamer girl. Oh god, are you really gonna say legendary gamer girl? I mean, they exist in quite large quantities, actually. Like, gamer girls are a pretty big amount of people. Like, just saying they're legendary is kind of rude. Like, I never thought I'd see the legendary not annoying gamer guy. See how dumb that sounds? But if any of my friends fit that description, it's Yui. She looks entirely focused on the game, as though I'm not even there.
Ah, damn it. I was this close to getting a perfect score.
I looked at the screen to try and figure out which game Yui was playing. Tempo Paradise, huh?
You know it?
Yeah, I'm not the best at rhythm games, though.
I could tell from the way you just made me lose.
What? That wasn't my fault.
Sure it wasn't.
Yui shut down her console and put it aside.
Are you here to talk about what happened yesterday? Because I don't have anything to say.
I'm not here to interrogate you or anything. I'm just here to see how you're doing.
I'm fine, Hideki. It wasn't a big deal.
So, you're not mad at me?
I will be if you keep asking me these stupid questions.
Okay, fair enough. I figured Yui wouldn't want to talk. This conversation has already gone on for longer than I thought it would.
Do you like her?
The music just cut abruptly, so that was weird. What? Huh? Where did that come from?
I see you hanging out with her quite a lot, so I was just curious.
I don't know. I like being around her. She's pretty upbeat and fun. But I can't really tell if I have feelings for her or anything.
Huh.
Don't ask me these kinds of questions. You're making me all confused.
That's the point. I like messing with you.
She said that with a smile, too. Classic Yui. You can mess with me later. It's time when I went back to class. Are you coming?
No, I'll stay here a bit longer.
Dude, the exams are literally days away. Can you really afford to miss classes now?
Just go back to class, Hideki. You're the one who needs them.
Suit yourself. I'll see you later, then. I waved goodbye to Yui and walked to class. Okay, great. Break time rolled around, and Megumi was still at her desk, vigilantly writing her notes on the board. Damn, that was a lot of information. I can't believe all this will be on the exams. I got most of it down, but the teacher rubbed off most of it before I had the chance. My efforts are getting me nowhere. I should do something else for a while to take my mind off studying. These are my only options, huh? Well, let's go to the literary club, I guess. I should probably pay the club room a visit. I don't want to become a member in name only. I walked into the hallway and started heading towards the club room. Yo, Misaki senpai.
Eh? Oh, Hideki, you scared me for a second. What's with the formalities?
I don't know, just for fun, I guess. I walked inside after closing the door behind me, then sat on the couch. I didn't think I'd find you in the club room, since I came here straight after class. Even so, you still beat me here.
Seems like I'm faster than you, Hideki.
You probably are, considering how out of shape I am. But I'd say the real reason is that the club room is on the same floor as your classroom.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Huh, you said it as if you didn't already know.
Of course I did. I was just messing with you.
Yeah, I should have seen that one coming. So, Chinatsu.
Yes?
Why don't we continue what we started last time?
What? Did we do something last time? When? What? How?
I'm talking about this short story.
Oh, A Lone Universe?
Yes, Chinatsu.
Yes, okay. That makes much more sense.
More sense than what? Chinatsu walked over to the window and picked up the novel that was sitting right next to it.
Alright, should I begin reading?
Wait, let me get more comfortable. Okay, much better.
Don't you fall asleep.
Don't worry, I won't.
Okay, let's continue. The boy grew closer and closer to his destination. As he got close enough, he started looking around. The cottage wasn't big, but at the same time, it wasn't very small either. It looked just right to him. The boy walked to the door and knocked 3 times, but there was no answer. Again, the boy knocked 3 times. No answer. Just as the boy was about to leave, he heard the door being unlocked. A little girl was looking at him from the small gap between the door. "Hello there, little one. Do you live here by yourself?" the boy asked. She shook her head. As she did, a little boy and another girl came to the door. The girl who opened the door and the other boy look younger than me, thought the boy to himself. But the blonde girl is probably the same age as me, if not 1 year older. "The 3 of us live here," said the blonde girl. The boy told the 3 of them about his situation and how he was lost. Nowhere to go, just walking aimlessly, he came across a small cottage. Not knowing the reason why, the blonde girl invited him in and said he could stay for however long he wanted. Maybe they felt pity for me, the boy thought, or maybe they just want to help me. The boy was confused, but at the same time, he was happy that he had found a place to stay and people to interact with. The cottage wasn't very big from the inside, but 4 people could fit nicely in it. Some of the walls were patched up, and there was only 1 window looking out to the backside of the cottage. The 3 of them had the table ready. The boy wasn't hungry, but there was something about eating food with others that just made him do it. The boy was happy with the cottage. He liked the place and the people in it. And so he started staying there. But after time passed, he wasn't just staying, he was living there. It became his home. The 4 of them were so happy together. They would always play outside and run down the big meadows, only to come back when the suns went down and gather around a small fire while talking all night. Many days and nights went by. They were having so much fun that they didn't even keep track of the time. But that didn't last. One day, the boy decided to go to sleep early instead of sitting next to the fire. And when he woke up, the 3 kids were nowhere to be seen. The boy walked over to the window and looked outside. No one was there. The cottage was empty, and the wind was howling strongly between the wooden cracks. For the first time, he realized how scary that place was. He walked to the door and went outside, hoping to find one of them. But he was the only one there. And that's the end of Act 2. We should stop here for now.
Oh, what? Things were just getting deep. I wonder what happened.
It's pretty interesting, isn't it?
It sure is. I never thought I'd like this type of story this much.
I knew you would like it.
Then you must know me better than I know myself.
I should hope so.
I'm really digging this whole club thing. You make it seem really fun. But the bell already rang, so I should hurry back to class before my teacher loses it.
Yeah, I should do the same.
I'll try and see you later, and if not, I'll see you after the exams. Good luck with your studies, Chinatsu.
You too, Hideki. Bye.
Waving Shinatsu a final farewell, I walked over to the door and headed back to class. Well, that was fun. By the time school ended for the day, I had exhausted every fiber of my being. Writing down notes, worrying about Yui and Megumi, and stressing about exams all at once was taking its toll. As a result, by the time I had written down all the notes for the day, I was literally the last student to go home. Hey, Mom.
Oh, Hideki, you're home early today.
Really? I'm pretty sure I was the very last student to leave school. I guess it must be because I came straight home for once.
You didn't go out with your friends today.
I thought I'd just spend the evening in my room, catching up on some sleep. The others are probably preparing for the exams anyway.
You should do the same, you know.
Yeah, I will. But the only thing on my mind right now is food. All this studying has me starved.
The studying you haven't been doing, you mean? Either way, you're right on time, and dinner will be ready in 5 minutes. Go wash up, and then join me in the kitchen.
Go wash up? I haven't washed my hands for dinner since I was like a kid. Like, I don't even think in high school I was washing my hands before dinner. I just spit on my hands, rub them together, and call clean.
Okay. Well, let me get some water here for a second. Sweet, sweet water. After eating dinner with my mother, I returned to my bedroom. I promised I would study, but the second my head hit the pillow, my body had other ideas. I don't know why I'm so tired today. Is the schoolwork getting to me? Is it stress? Am I worried about my friends? At any rate, all I want to do now is sleep the night away. And that's what I'm doing right now. Oh, skipping through May. Look at that. Look at time just fly. Oh my god, time is flying. It's a week. It was a whole week. I just was in a coma for a week. It's crazy, guys. As the days leading up to my exam period rapidly passed by, I found myself once again waking up without feeling refreshed in the slightest. Although my usual nightmares have kept at bay, the monster known as studying has been ruining my life. I have been getting little sleep lately, and with summer break riding on the results of my upcoming exams, that won't change anytime soon.
Good morning, honey. Ready for your last day of school?
I would be if school wasn't being replaced by mandatory studying and exams. Honestly, who decides to give us a week off school solely for the purpose of studying, only to then drag us back for exams?
Fair enough.
School has been tiring recently, and now the exams are here. I just want this week to be over.
Don't worry, it'll be over before you know it. You kids these days want to rush everything instead of enjoying your youth.
No, I want to rush my exams precisely so I can go out with my friends and enjoy my youth.
Huh. Okay, good point. You're really on the ball this morning, Hidi. All the studying must have given you super focus.
Don't worry, it'll fade in a week or so.
I'm not sure how to feel about that. I want you to do well, but it's so unnatural to see you so focused on something other than video games.
Just how little faith does my mother have in me?
Anyway, I guess it's about time you left. You don't want to be late for your last day of class.
If you say so. Later, Mom. I finished eating and waved goodbye as I walked out the door. There aren't many people here today. It seems like some of the students decided to stay home studying, or at least that's what they'll tell their teachers. Maybe I should have done the same. Boring.
Psst, Hideki.
What?
Let's get out of here.
What?
This class is so boring, and it's just a revision of what we've been learning before. So let's just ditch and go into town or something.
I don't know. Ryu's right about all this boring being stuff we've done before, but even so, stay in class. We'd better stay in class. I don't want to get in trouble on the last day.
Psst, what trouble? There are like 10 people here, including us. I'm pretty sure he won't mind.
Let's not risk it.
You're no fun, Hideki. Have it your way.
Ryu walked over to his desk and sat down. Sorry, Ryu, but I have studying to do. If you want to fail the exams and attend summer school, that's your problem. With all the excitement from my day having passed by, I stared blankly at the ceiling in my room. I had neither the energy nor the desire to study anymore, and simply wanted summer vacation to arrive. I can't believe summer vacation is almost here already. I've been here for a full 2 months now, and it's gotten to the point where I really do feel like this is my home. I've had so much fun here. I never thought I'd make so many friends so easily. Huh. On the other hand, I've spent so much time worrying about my friends and trying to be sociable that I haven't had any time to myself. My entire school life had just been me jumping from one person to the next, either listening to their problems or allowing them to create more for me. Huh. No, that's unfair. Even if friendships breed conflict, I brought all this upon myself, and it's not as though they mean any harm. Besides, from tomorrow on, I'll have all the alone time I need. In the depths of studying hell. Ooh, May 1st. Wait, what? I was right! It went from May to June! It was May 1st, and then it's June 1st now! What the hell? You can't do that, man! That is a super big typo! You need to fix that shit immediately! Fix it! Fix it now! Also, the ceiling light is not proportional. I am not okay with the ceiling light not being a circular object. Instead, it is like an egg shape, and I don't like it. That's not how ceiling lights look. God damn it. Scribble, scribble. Scribble, scribble. Scribble, scribble. Just kill me now. My first day of full-on exam preparation, and I'm already bored out of my mind. This is absolutely not how I wanted to spend my weekend. But the exams are 1 week away from today, so I can't afford not to study. I just need to quit complaining, buckle down, and study my ass off. Scribble, scribble. Scribble, scribble. I wonder what Megumi is doing. Study. No brain, stop it. You don't really want to know what she's doing, you just don't want to study. Now, back to work, and don't even think about distracting my friends. Now it's June. Now it says June all of a sudden. It was May last time, and now it's June. Captain's log, day 3. After 2 days of isolation, I could feel myself succumbing to unnatural desires. Surrounded by only my books, I continue my studies of human culture, all the while longing for human contact. The feel, the touch, the smell of another human being. All sensations I have yearned for since my isolation began. Okay, I really do need to talk to someone. All this studying is driving me insane. Maybe I should send Shiro a text message? Keep studying. No, I can't risk infecting her with my insanity. I'll just keep studying until I pass out. Still not happy with this June thing, man. I'm just never going to be happy with it. And the wizard dies at the end of the movie. Everyone saw it coming, but I was still mad when Megumi spoiled it for me. Okay. But enough about that. How was your day? Are you sure you're not just using me as a way to avoid your studying? Whoa, you should become a detective or something. Who says I'm not one already? I wouldn't be surprised. Now head back to your studies before I call the high authority, young man. Fine. Scribble, scribble. Scribble, scribble. Wow, this is even more complicated than math. I need a little break. Maybe I should contact Yui? We haven't spoken since that study break began. Text Yui. It'd be rude of me to ignore her any longer. I don't want Yui to get too lonely in my absence. Yui-chan!
Go back to your studying, Hideki.
You're always so mean to me.
I'm saying this for your own good.
Sure you are. Anyways, what you watching?
Playing some Dragon Fantasy VIII.
You what? Playing a JRPG 2 days before the finals?
Yeah, so what? I'll start studying tomorrow.
Start? You didn't start yet?
Of course not. Who studies finals for more than one day?
Everyone except you, apparently.
Is that so?
Yes, I've been busting my butt studying for this. Funny thing is, you'll probably get the highest mark in the class.
That's a given.
Wow, thanks. Yui and I kill time chatting about video games, taking my productivity to an all-time low. Yeah, it's all right. I've been pretty good about studying the rest of the time, so I think I'm okay to text Yui once.
Besides, we gotta set up that Yui route so when we go on the school vacation or whatever, we can go talk with her.
Yes, that sounds about right. And if I apply this theory to my own life, then I can finally confirm how fucking bored I am. I threw my book at the wall. Well, that was pointless and stupid. Speaking of which, maybe I should reply to one of the 125 texts Ryu sent me. Study, study, study. I'll see him tomorrow anyway. And finals begin tomorrow, so I should really finish all this. After awaking from what I could only conclude to be a study-induced coma, I found myself at school sitting at my desk. Time for exams, huh? Alright, let's get this show on the road. Time to... As I look around the room, I realize that I was alone. What the heck? Wait a minute. Could this mean the exams are already over? Huh. No, wait. Something isn't right. It's eerily quiet in here. Almost as though...
Are you scared?
Huh? I looked over at the teacher's desk again and saw someone who looked exactly like me standing there. You again. Wait, I remember him from somewhere. Have I seen him in another dream? But if I know that I'm dreaming, does that mean this is a lucid dream?
You look stressed. Is this really what's stressing you out? Exams. How juvenile.
Is he mocking me? What do you want from me?
I am merely making sure you are walking the right path.
Right path? What the hell are you talking about?
The truth.
Okay, that was great. Great. No, that was great. That was great. That was great. That was great. Spooky. Oh, boy, oh, boy. Huh. Damn, what a dream. Just what I need before my first day of exams. All right, the time has come. You can do this, Hideki.
Good morning, Hideki.
What's so good about it? Today marks the first day of the dreaded exams.
Aw, don't be like that. Today is a fantastic day, and you know why?
Because we're one day closer to summer break?
Well, there's that. But mostly because I finally get to see you again.
Calm down, Megumi. It's only been 1 week.
Yeah, but it feels like an eternity. Next time you're in full study mode, we'll have to call me at least once a night, okay? Otherwise, I'll come to your house and make sure you're alright.
Seriously? Okay, I get it. Maybe I was a bit too much of a hermit. The next time I lock myself up in my room, I'll make sure to...
Take me with you?
To call you.
Good enough.
This girl is scary.
Anyway, we can worry about sleeping arrangements later. Just forget about everything and let's focus on our exams.
Yeah, you're right.
I'll go to my desk now and study a bit more before the professor comes. Good luck, Hideki.
Good luck to you, too. Huh. Wait, what was that about sleeping arrangements?
Now that everyone is prepared, let us begin the first exam.
As teachers flooded the classroom, we all focused on the test papers in front of us. Here goes nothing. Scribble, scribble. Scribble, scribble. Okay, that's one down. No time to rest now. Scribble, scribble. Scribble, scribble.
Is everyone ready for the last day of exams?
Huh. Aside from the odd sigh here and there, the class remained silent.
Wonderful. Then without further ado, let us begin.
It's all over. The final exam conquered at last. Until we start anew tomorrow.
Hello, Hideki.
Hey there, Shiro. How'd you do today?
I'm not really sure. How about you?
I'd say I'm in the same clueless ship as you. Maybe I did well. Maybe I crashed and burned.
Heh, I get that feeling every time I walk out of an exam.
Yep, and tomorrow this will repeat all over again.
Yeah, with that in mind, I should hurry home and cram a little.
Alright, I'll probably do the same. See you tomorrow.
Bye-bye.
Ugh, Shiro's voice always makes me have a runny nose. Alright. Ooh, what is it, a Saturday, Sunday? I didn't pay attention. Saturday, there we go. Anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and say thank you guys for watching. If you liked what you see, go ahead and click subscribe. Always leave a comment in the comment section below. Tell me the worst no one but you player you've ever seen. As always, thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time, and
bye!